across the border from Brownsville, Texas, on what's happening inside of a migrant camp there. Riff, good morning.
Hey, Bill, good morning to you. That's right. We're just outside that camp that closed, and that DHS White House team came just across the border from me. We want to give you a look, though. We have a drone shot that we'll take now. This river, the Rio Grande River, is the U.S.-Mexico border. Matamoros on my side, Brownsville, Texas, and the Rio Grande Valley on that side. But if you look at this camp was open for over 2 years, put in place with the Trump-era policy known as MPP or Remain in Mexico, kept asylum seekers on this side of the border while they waited for their claims to play out. Well, guess what? In the last 24 hours, it has closed. Most all of the inhabitants inside this camp were allowed to cross into the U.S., and many of them released at that bus station we saw in Brownsville. All you're looking at now is the debris and trash within this camp that accrued over 2 years. The NGO organization Doctors Without Borders calling it, quote, inhumane conditions for anyone to live in. Many of them families, a lot of children, a very difficult place to spend upwards of 2 years. We talked to some of the migrants that were still out here that have not been allowed to cross. One of them is a gentleman named Mario with his family here. He's from Honduras. He's been here about 8 months trying to cross.
Who gives a shit about him?
The Biden administration will be more favorable to his cause. Take a listen to what he said.
The president.
Let's hear about the COVID-19 infected migrants.
In El Salvador.
Representatives from Doctors Without Borders have described it as a humanitarian crisis. I just want to make sure I have that right and just have, get a little bit more on that.
Well, they've described the conditions when this camp was open as inhumane conditions. Didn't say a crisis from what I've through Guatemala, Congressman Henry Cuellar, in capacity,
By the way, they showed a graphic where there's like 130 something migrants that are already infected with COVID, and they're all cramped with 5,000 migrants. Unbelievable.